guys, welcome back to my channel, Danielle here, and we've got Luisa, Funky Cool Threads. She is no stranger to this channel. We are outside of Thrift City, and you guys, I'm not in Los Angeles. We're actually in the Central Valley. We're in
Fresno.
So we're gonna go on in. I don't really have a budget, not really looking for anything really
specific. We're just kinda gonna, you know, roam the streets.
Also have a saved live on my Instagram, so if you guys want to check it out, I am at @Twinelle_ right over there. If you guys want to check out Luisa, her Depop, her Instagram, I'll leave all her social media down below in the description. But you guys, let's go on in.
You guys, we just got here and it looks like on Sundays they don't open until 10, and it is currently 9 a.m. so we're gonna hit up another thrift store.
We are at stop number 2. The other thrift location was actually closed. They don't open till 10, so now we are at Thrift City. So let's go on in and see what we find.
This is what I have so far. We have this No Boundaries maxi skirt. I am loving this, especially the slit on the back. This is very much more fall, but it's XOXO, so I'm kind of living for it. Plus, you can never go wrong with the plaid piece. And then this one here, oh my goodness. But this waist, I think is about maybe a 22, 23 inch waist. And I'm a 26, 27. So I think I still might take it with me because we could rock a really grungy look with this. And then lastly is this wet seal dress, but it's going for $10. And for wet seal, I don't know if it's worth it, but it's very much like trashy Y2K, which I'm living for.
Okay guys, round 2, it's finally open now, so we're gonna go on in and see what we find. Pieces that I picked up. The lingerie is so good. So we have this one here. Ooh, look at this. I feel like the cup size is gonna be obviously a little too big for me, but we also have this one here. I love the little vent in the front. And then the one that's gonna fit me for sure is this one here. How freaking cute is this? You just sorting your stuff? You guys, it's been a few days since I last went thrifting with Luisa, and it's also one of those days where I'm just like, I don't like my makeup, I don't like my outfit, I don't like my hair. Why did I think it'd be good to try mascara on for like the first time in a year? And then I didn't like it, so I tried to remove it without messing up my makeup, and it just doesn't look the way I want it to. And then I got the idea that, ooh, I should do something different with my hair, spice it up a little bit. And now I'm left with these like curly baby bangs that I don't feel really fit my look for today. So I'm kind of stuck with this. But let's talk about the reason why y'all are here. This thrift haul from Visalia. I usually always talk about how the prices are pretty damn awesome. The clothes is literally untouched when we're talking about like Y2K, 90s pieces. But this time around, prices kind of steep. I walked away with a dress, a wet seal dress, for $10. And you're just like, what? A brand new dress at wet seal would literally cost you 10 bucks. So, you know, a few pieces here and there were just like, why you price that high. But I did end up walking away with pieces that I really like. So let's get started with the first item. I wanna first show off this little zip vest because it is my favorite out of the entire haul. And look at how freaking cute. I was immediately sold with the little leopard details, and I actually got this little mini skirt from a mystery bundle, but doesn't this look like it would be sold together? It is so freaking cute. I'm also thinking that this might be a kid's just because it does fit cropped and very fitted. So on me, it fits more like an extra small. The only thing that sucks about it is that the zipper is a little busted. I have pretty small boobs, and sometimes the zipper just like busts open at random times. So I did manage to get it closed, but let me bring you in closer because look at this little flower detail. Freaking adorable, right? And then we do have detailed buttons. The leopard print is pretty tactile, so it's very soft to touch. And then a little thing that I really like that probably doesn't matter to a lot of people is this little vent here. So a lot of the Y2K clothing that I come across has vents here on the front, so you can show up a little bit of tummy and make it a little bit more flirty. And this already has it, so it's just like, yes, so freaking cute. So either with this mini skirt or like leather pants, how awesome would that be? So super love that I got this one, and it was only like $3. The next one I wanna show off is this super cute cami. I feel like they're such essentials right now in summer because it's so freaking hot. So just finding a cute little piece to throw on like this is so freaking easy. But let me bring you in closer because we have the lace trim. Look at this print. It's so freaking groovy. It does have like pretty bright colors too. And then my favorite part is this silver hardware baby fat detail. Ideally, I would like to pair this with a mini skirt, but after going through all my mini skirts, I realized they're all very dark colored and more suited for fall. So definitely have to look for that when I'm out at the thrift, but such a cute little versatile piece. So I don't really follow trends very often just because I thrift a lot of my clothes, but I couldn't resist this whole scarf top trend. I love. So when I found this really like geometric printed one, I had to take it with me. The only thing I don't like is that it does have tassels on the ends. So I might just snip those off to be honest. But this scarf was one of those pieces where I was just like, why are you priced so much? Because it was $5 and scarves here in LA are usually $3 and under. So I was just like, come on Central Valley. That is a little too expensive for a damn scarf. But I really do love how versatile scarf tops are. Depending on your bust size, there are literally endless ways to tie them. I found for my smaller bust, a little twist front is the best support just because it really does lift and hug your boobs. But yeah, super supportive, feels very comfy. I feel like this time around, I can move around and no nip slips. Up next is this little slip. It really is giving me Cinderella, but in lingerie form. I absolutely love this. I've already worn it out with a leather jacket, black tights, my Demonias, and I think it looks really cute. Only thing is that it is lined, but it is very much see-through. So I definitely kind of kept it cohesive with the black and wore a black strapless bra and black high-waisted undies, just so that, you know, it could fit more of that grungy look. But I absolutely love this. It is mesh construction. Oh, I also forgot to mention, it's Betsy Johnson. And this one was pretty pricey. I think this one was $12.99. But I mean, it's pretty much worth it. It's also very waste-free and flowy. So you can have a big meal, conceal the food baby, and still look very cute and comfy. The next dress is this one here. And you guys are probably wondering like, Danielle, why did you pick that up? Because I've mentioned it multiple times, I don't like bodycon dresses, but the sequins, the asymmetrical straps are what sold me, and not gonna lie you guys, but I've thrifted this exact dress before and I sold it on Depop. And every once in a while, I'll think about that dress and be like, wow, Danielle, you really shouldn't have sold it. It has so much potential because I'm actually gonna thrift flip this, you guys. Imagine it being a two-piece set with a little crop top and then a fitted mini skirt. That would look so freaking cute. This is giving me very much club vibes. I am in my 20s and I've never been to a freaking club. I actually moved to downtown so that I can experience nightlife just a little bit more, but I've been here for 6 months and I still haven't been to a single club, and literally across the street from me is a club. So if any of you girlies wanna take me out for drinks, hit me up in my DMs. But look at these straps. The asymmetrical look, I absolutely love. Oh, you guys, also, this is a dress that I was telling you is wet seal, and I paid $10 for it, but It's okay, I think it's worth it. Hopefully I don't mess it up with a thrift flip. I have planned for it, so fingers crossed. Up next is this little lingerie mesh dress. I think it's super cute, but I'm gonna wear it more as a top just so that I can actually wear it out in public, because I did show it in the thrift clips, but it is very see-through. It's not short, surprisingly, but you know, if you wear it out in public with just this alone, you're gonna be showing a lot of cheeks. So instead, I'm just gonna wear it as like a bustier top. These cups actually fit me. I love this bright turquoise color. And then anything with lace, obviously, is super feminine. And we just have this little bow detail too. But really love that it has adjustable straps. And then the bodice is mesh, so it is kind of sexy too. I just paired it with some really structured leather trousers, and low-key kind of think it looks like professional, but like sexy professional. And then the only piece of advice I have for you guys is that if you really do love lingerie pieces like corsets or slips, go hit up the thrifts in very conservative towns, because here in LA, every reseller is going after lingerie pieces. But if you go to really conservative towns, all the lingerie is literally untouched. No one wants it. So both Luisa and I walked away with so many lingerie pieces. And if you haven't watched Luisa's video yet, go check it out, because she walked away with like a crap ton of corsets and bustier tops. This next piece I actually didn't find, Luisa did, and I'm so glad she gave it to me because I think it's so freaking cute. I also don't have a lot of purple in my wardrobe, so when I saw this, I was like, yes. Kind of gave me Selena vibes, but now that I have it styled, I was trying to go for this very like gothic, dark type of look, but tell me why I'm getting more Xena warrior princess vibes. But you know what, I'm still here for it. She's strong and she kicks ass, so we are just gonna go with it. And it's actually not a mini skirt, it's actually more of a knee length, and it does have an elasticized waistband, but I have it literally right below my boobs, and then I put the corset over it so we can have much more of a shorter hemline. I feel like nowadays I am taking major inspiration from Ashley from Best Dress, because she loves her shorter hemlines, and so am I lately. We are finally moving on to pants now, and these I absolutely love, and they fit a little big, but I feel like maybe after a big meal I can fill them in pretty nicely. But look at the sheen, look at the shine. I usually am not attracted to like this beige or a tan color because I'm sometimes scared to look a little nude, but I have been getting pretty tan, so I feel like it complements my skin pretty nicely. But let me bring you in a little closer just so that you can actually see the sheen to it, because yes, I think it definitely fits that very like Y2K type look. We also just have a classic flare leg, and then my favorite part, you guys, look at the butt. We have tiny little embellishments on the back patch pockets. I am noticing you can see my underwear line, which isn't the most flattering, so I think I'm gonna have to wear like no-show panties instead, because they are pretty thin, which makes it pretty comfortable, but I didn't take that into account. Underwear lines are very visible. You guys know that I'm pretty open-minded with clothes, but I am trying with all my might to feel cute in this outfit, but I just can't do it. I'm giving major suburban mom vibes, and I am not here for it. And I don't think it's the capris, because I actually really like capris. I think it's more this Hawaiian hibiscus print. I just don't know how to style it. But let me just bring you in a little bit closer, because these pants, as far as like the style and the cut, are pretty cool. We do have the zip front here. It is super high-waisted, no belt loops, and no butt pockets, so it looks really nice and flattering. And surprisingly, they fit me too, because I don't run into a lot of pants that fit me true to size, and these fit super nicely and hug me in all the right places. It's just this print. I cannot do it with this print. So if you have any little tips and bits of advice on how to make this a bit more me, let me know down in the comments. Otherwise, these are probably gonna go straight onto my Depop. But you guys, that pretty much does it for the end of this Visalia thrift haul. If you liked any of the pieces, let me know in the comments down below. I do recommend that you guys go hit up the Valley, especially for those super cheap prices, or if you're into those really like risque type of pieces, conservative neighborhoods or towns are probably gonna be for you. I also forgot to mention that last Wednesday I posted a video, but I was having major tech issues when trying to upload it, so notifications didn't go out for it at all. So you guys, I do plan on uploading that same video on Wednesday, so if you see the same video going up, don't be alarmed, that's me. But I will leave the link of that video down below, so please, you guys, if you can support and watch it, I would totally appreciate it. But you guys, as always, I do post videos twice a week. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!